So can you drop a column from a partition table when some of the partitions are compressed? Yeah, sure. You can write alter table table name, drop column column name. Oops, it gave an error stating you cannot drop columns like this if your table is partitioned and compressed. Now why would you even compress a table partition and when should you do it? Well, Oracle or database storage is expensive. Suppose you have huge amount of data that you barely access, like transactions older than 3 years. This data is never updated, but you may need to keep it for bookkeeping purposes or for the occasional analysis. Now imagine this is taking huge amount of space in your disk. It makes sense to partition such datasets and to compress the partitions that do not change and are not accessed frequently. If you do not understand partitions and the concept of partition pruning, I have made a separate series of videos on it. I will drop a link to it in the description. So how can we drop a column in such scenario? Well, it's a straightforward 4-step process. You set the column you want to drop as unused. You uncompress the compressed partitions of the table using move partition. You drop the unused columns and you compress the required partitions again. Let's see this with an example. I have created a table and I have implemented range partitioning on it. I have compressed 2 partitions and I have inserted 100,000 rows into this table. We can verify the partition details using the user tab partition metadata table. Here we have 5 partitions and the first 2 partitions P1 and P2 are compressed. Now we want to drop the column quantity from this table, so we will have to set it to unused. I will paste all these DDLs and DMLs in the description so that you can also replicate and test this at your end. Now for the second step, we need to identify the partitions that are in compressed state and we have to uncompress them. If we have a number of compressed partitions, we can use this query to dynamically generate the alter statement to uncompress our partitions. Let's copy these statements and we will run them. Now our partitions are uncompressed. We can go ahead and drop our unused column using this syntax. The column is now dropped and finally we can compress the partitions again that we had uncompressed in our second step. Let's query our table and verify that the column has been dropped. That is the case. Let's query our metadata table as well to verify that the 2 partitions are compressed again. That is the case. So using this 4-step method, you can easily drop a column from a partition table. If you want to learn more about partitions, compression strategy, and performance optimization, please hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon. And if you have any questions related to this video, please drop a comment and I'll be happy to help.